This is the scene. I'm going to have Charlie just kind of walk through and show you. This is where it happened. This very narrow alleyway in Itaewon, which is the very popular nightclub district here in Seoul. They hold a huge Halloween party every year. People fly in from all over for this. The hotels in this area are booked up, and you can just see how it's lined with all of the trash on the side of the street. And it was packed with literally piles of people, Pamela. This is the big question is, you know, there were warnings on loudspeakers, and there's videos on social media showing this, you know, telling people that they needed to be careful, and yet thousands of people kept coming into this area. Of course, this is the first Halloween celebration in 3 years where they didn't have pandemic restrictions in South Korea, so there were no masks required, no limits on crowd size. The big question, the unanswered question, as they continue to investigate out here this morning is, was this just a case of people getting overly excited and just wanting to be in there and party, or did something else trigger this presumed stampede that caused so many deaths? You're talking about almost 150 lives lost, something that has never happened here in Itaewon. I'm going to actually toss to some sound from one of the people who was packed inside this narrow alleyway, which we're about to show you. Charlie, just walk past it, show people just how narrow this was. He describes what it was like to be stuck with thousands of people in this very narrow alley. The scary moments that he experienced when at one point he had a hard time even breathing and he couldn't move at all. Listen.
And I saw the people like going to the left side, and I actually saw the person actually getting to the opposite side. So actually the person in the middle, they got jammed, and they have like, you know, no way to communicate, and they like, you know, they cannot breathe.
后，很多人都指出，因为当时有一位名人男星，他要造访的是当地的某一间酒吧，所以导致人潮不断的聚集。而其中的某一位直播主 K， 他就被认为说是罪魁祸首。但是呢，这名直播主他后来就发表声明喊冤，说自己也是被推挤的。声明中表示说自己在人潮推挤之下，再被推进了酒吧，之后在店员的建议之下，就干脆在店里头待了一阵子，等到人潮稍稍的疏散，他才成功的离开现场。这名直播主也指出，他跟合作平台交代了当天的行程，希望大众不要再传播假讯息了。
民众大力推挤，神情慌张，想逃离人潮。但有目击者向警方表示，当时有5到6位韩国男性不但故意推挤，还大喊推大力一点，才导致悲剧发生。目前警方正在调阅监视器进行调查。
有一位卡在人群当中的外籍金发男子看到状况逐渐失控，他就跳到另外一个店家的墙上开始攀爬，一路爬到两层楼高的招牌上头自救，仿佛就像是蜘蛛人一样。网友就说他求生欲真的非常的强烈。不止这一名外籍人士，还有一对情侣也是赶快踩到附近的墙上逃离人群。网友就指出说，踩到这个高处或是躲到厕所是遇到踩踏的时候是最好的逃生方法。
很多幸存者陆续在社群媒体上发出当时的情况。有一名男子，他当天晚上刚好带着妻小到梨泰院，但是他立刻警觉，再不走的话就会有憾事发生。情急之下，他将自己的孩子交给一旁酒吧的客人，随后他和妻子跨越栏杆进入酒吧，在事发前的20分钟顺利逃生。
梨泰院推挤意外事发当下人潮汹涌，许多人伸手抓住栏杆，还是被人流继续往前推，茫茫人海中竟然也有小孩受困其中。一名男子透过电台表示，当天带着妻小到梨泰院，意外发生前已经被挤到动弹不得，当下惊觉再不走可能会死，赶紧转进小巷请求酒吧里的外国人帮忙。男子脱身时间大约是晚上10点，20分钟后就爆发推挤意外。男子也表示，事发后许多人指控店家不开门，群众无处可逃，导致伤亡增加。他认为可能是店家不知道外面发生意外，并非故意不开门。有酒吧老板得知消息，立刻冲出店外拯救多条人命。
그래서누르고만해고치고로내려가고
伤患遍布整条窄巷，许多人受到推挤拉扯，身上的衣物残破不堪。有获救民众的妹妹在确认现场遗留物品时，发现姐姐身上多出一件黑色的运动上衣。她在网络发文表示，可能是某位好心人帮忙穿上的，希望能找到人亲自道谢。
22-year-old French exchange student filmed herself with friends, at first laughing, but then she suddenly looks distressed.
踩踏悲剧幸存的法籍学生表示，起初人群推挤时大家还觉得好玩，完全没有危机意识，不知道情况会走向失控。
At some point I had no air and we were so crushed to other people that I couldn't breathe at all, so I just passed out.
罹难者中有不少外籍游客或是外籍学生，大批相约在南韩户外口罩令解除后的第一个万圣节周末赴梨泰院狂欢，数小时就涌入了将近10万人。而事发的斜坡仅是条4公尺不到的窄巷，根本不堪负荷庞大人潮。
Mrs. Steven to tell him like, hey, don't come to our place anymore.
有美籍交换生表示，当晚就注意到庞大人潮涌入梨泰院，还提醒友人不要前往，但挚友却从此没有回复讯息，成了踩踏意外的罹难者。而他们的同学同样出现在罹难者名单上，三人前几天才一起去爬山践行，令人不胜唏嘘。
Person, like a great friend, I'm gonna miss him.
原本精彩的交换生生涯却成了无比悲痛的回忆。梨泰院事故让韩国社会陷入巨大冲击，更让全球许多将举行的大型活动提升警戒，避免悲剧再度重演。
It's just like a joke. I don't think in such a festival there would be some young people just like me died. So I almost suicide. I saw somebody.Lying on the road, and they were wearing the costume. I was so sorry for them.
梨泰院意外现场附近设置了祭拜区，提供民众哀悼这些不幸身亡的罹难者。南韩在昨天宣布，国家哀悼期将有7天。另外，根据了韩联社的报道，有一名在梨泰院当地一间超商工作、不愿透露姓名的20多岁男子表示，当时看到的现场情况，他脑子里想到的只有必须再多救一个人。他回想，他大概是扛了50多个人，是一位标准的无名英雄。Thank you.